So for a long time, I wanted to make a video like this that takes a real business and takes it all the way through. And fortunately, I've now got an opportunity to do that with a business that needs to be registered correctly. And then we need to then show the whole process. And you're going to join me on that as we go through that over the next few weeks. But just in case you're not 100% sure what Google My Business is, in effect, it's the greatest way you could optimize your business. You may have heard of SEO, search engine optimization. Well, this is a way to put your business in front of your customers so that you get local customers phoning you up. It's a bit like Checkatrade. It's a bit like Yellow Pages or Yale. It's a bit like perhaps other indexes and citations you've had before, but this is with Google themselves. So it puts you on Google Maps. It puts you before people when they're searching. So the next person who searches for a plumber, they find your business coming up in the search engine. And of course, going forward, people are using voice search, using Google Maps, they're using Google search engines, they're using devices, they're using tablets, they're using mobiles, they're using laptops. All these things are being used to find businesses locally. This is going to show you how you can make sure your business is in front of the right eyes on a local basis. So this is a really valuable set or series of videos I'm going to be making now. And I want you to make sure that you don't miss one along the way. So make sure you subscribe. And if you click the bell, it'll notify you of when the next update comes as well. So that's really important if you want to follow this series. Now, as this episode runs, it will come across various issues and problems that no doubt we all find. And I'm going to show you my workarounds. I'm going to show you the tools I use, some of the software that could be used as well. So you'll find that as this series progresses, it'll start to build your business too. And you'll find that you're gradually getting more interest, you're getting more clients, you're more customers, but you may come across a few problems too. And those things will be addressed as we go along the way. So how's this video actually going to work in this series? Well, it's a little bit, it reminds me very much of the time when I used to have adventure books. So probably just before the internet came along, you could choose your own adventures. Maybe you've got books that you've come across like that before. This choose your own adventure style was that you would be in a situation and then you'd have to make a choice. If you want to go out through the door, then go to page 5 in the book. If you want to go out through the window, go to page 27. So you would choose one or the other, which was what you wanted to do. And then when you ended up there, you would then get another choice and so on. And that's the way these videos are going to work. A bit of a different way of using videos on YouTube in this particular episode, this particular series that I'm going to be doing. That I want at the end of the video, I want you then to choose which way you want to go. So on this video, you're going to see in a moment that you'll type in your business, and then from that, you're going to see which way you need to go. Do you need to register it as a brand new business, or do you need to make a claim for that business? Now, let me show you how that works by jumping in right now.
This is how it works. You go to business.google.com, and there you type in your business. And it's just important to know which type of business are you to know where to go from here. So let's, for example, say that you were called Keru. So this is just a fictional one that I know doesn't exist. So you notice here, Keru doesn't come up. It's never been registered as a business. So you would then create the business with this name. But as it works out, I know that the company that I will be registering is called LaRue, and LaRue Window Cleaning, which is the one we're going to cover. And you notice it does come up. So that is the business that I'll be optimizing. And so that's why you need to choose at this stage, when you type in your business, does it exist as in this one does, or does it come up where it doesn't exist so that in effect you then have to register a new business? So that's a choice you need to make at this stage.
So by the end of this series, you would have learned exactly how to optimize your business for Google My Business. You'd have learned the fundamentals, and you would have learned really all the things that I would do if you employed me to run your business for you. So this has great value, this series that I'm going to produce, because in effect, it's ideal for those that want to run their own business or manage their own business. It's ideal for those that perhaps want to manage other people's businesses and see how the professionals do that. It's ideal for people that already have their business, but they want to optimize it. They want to learn some of the tricks along the way. And it's ideal also if you've already done your business, you just want to know, have I done the right things? Have I perhaps picked up some bad habits? Are there things that I can do in the coming year that will get me ahead of the competition? Well, this series of videos is going to cover all those things and empower you to help you do the right thing and to find out tools that maybe you've not come across before. So in effect, as a web designer of 22 years, I'm going to use my experience to help you along the way. And I have to say, I've gone to various SEO marketers. I've gone down the avenue of doing SEO, search engine optimization, and I've always been very disappointed with the results they've produced. But I'm not disappointed with Google My Business, which is why it's probably the most powerful SEO that you could do for your business today. And that's why we're going to spend quite some time on this series going through these various episodes and choices that you need to make. And why do I think this series is going to be of value? Well, I say it's free because in effect it is of value, because this is the very thing that I'd be doing for your business. I've had quite a few people ask me, would I manage their business? And I had a choice. Do I want to do that, or do I want to just provide you so I can empower you to do your own optimization on your business? And in many ways, because Google My Business changes, because you know your business better than I do, then this felt that this would be a way to go. So hopefully this series is going to prove more valuable to you than it would be if you paid for my time. So for the next few weeks, get ready to follow along. Make sure you've subscribed, because if you don't do that, then you won't know when the next video comes out. And even if you have subscribed, it's the alert bell, the ring bell, that tells you when my next video is being released. And as we go along, we'll answer your questions in the comments below. You have my full attention over the coming weeks as I release this series or episodes and help you learn more about your business. So we now get to that point where it's the first choice for you to make in your adventure. Now, hopefully you've already checked to see which type of business do you have. Is it registered or is it not being registered at this point? So at this point, I want you to watch episode 2 if you have found that you've already got a registered business, but it's not being claimed. But if you've just found you've got no business whatsoever and you need to register it, then you need to go to this video here that will help you do that. I'll see you there at either one or the other.